Barbershop Chorus is very proud to be here singing for you tonight. We're going to sing some old songs and some new, some songs that you know and probably some you've never heard of before. And if we do it right, by the end of the evening, we'll all be exhausted. Much of the music we sing dates back to the turn of the century, and some even further, back to the days of the great riverboats. Now imagine, if you will, a southern gentleman traveling north by paddle wheel. After several days' journey on the river, he arrives at a small northern river port. Now, as the boat prepares to dock at the levee, he's alarmed by the large number of townspeople milling about, anxiously waiting their turn to board for the return trip south. Well, the man hastily gathers up his bag, makes his way down the gangplank to solid ground, steps around some cotton bales to avoid the crowd, and then he's spotted by an old acquaintance.
Well, what do you know?
Thank you.
a song that we performed in our society's international competition in 1989. This is a song that takes us back to the days of the old corn saloon and a honky-tonk piano man.
You want to hear some blues, you want to hear some jazz, well, let me tell you about my man. I reached when Dan was a piano man down at the corner saloon, saloon. For 30-odd years he brought laughter and tears. Oh, how he could handle a good old tune. But the patrons requested he played so fine. But one night some guy yelled,
sprang up alongside other forms of spontaneous vocal harmonizing. One style was the old-fashioned gospel quartet. It shares a lot in common with barbershop harmony. As a matter of fact, every barbershopper has a heartfelt love for a good gospel tune. And if you walk past the barbershop back around the turn of the century, after closing time, when the four barbers were harmonizing around the barber's chair, instead of hearing Sweet Adeline or Aura Lee, you might well have heard one of these good old tunes.
What grace that taught my heart to fear and praise my fear relieved? How precious did that grace appear the hour I first
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 1990 Illinois District 2nd Place Finalist Quartet, the Gateway Alliance!
Yeah.
standing sad and lonely through the many years. And so neglected, look at all the dust collecting. Wonder if you still could fill this room with joy and tears. Now, I don't have to say, take away the sorrow.
when they asked me to sing with these guys was that I got to sing with my brother David. It's been a while since we've sung together.
David, come on.
And, you know, it's really great to sing with David. But, you know, there's one thing I've been talking about that's kind of bothering me. Now, I know you date a lot of girls, and that's good to see, you know, but you've never gotten married.
No, I never have.
You know, I don't really understand. Is there a problem?
No, well, I guess kind of. Well, you know our parents real well, right?
Yeah. Okay.
And, you know, I'm very old-fashioned. We've come from a very old-fashioned background, and every time I meet a girl, I've got to take her home and meet parents. You know that. I mean, that's just the way it is. That's the way I'm taught. But there's one simple problem. Every time I bring home a girl, it doesn't matter how pretty she is, how good-looking she is, how nice she is, Mom cannot stand her.
Yeah.
Any girl, I don't care.
Yeah, she can.
I know she can. What am I supposed to do?
Well, I think I got an answer to your question.
I'll listen to
you. Probably.
Okay.
I got it. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay.
Hit me.
What you got to do is you go out and find a girl that's just like you. The same looks, same mannerisms.
Yeah.
Same. She's, you know, she's bound by her
man. I tried that once already.
Well, what happened?
Well, Mom liked her all right, but Dad couldn't stand her.
Songs from the big band era, Jukebox Saturday Night, all that good stuff. And we would like to do a song entitled for you now, just entitled Jukebox Smith.
Thank you.
it has been a tremendous pleasure for us to sing for you tonight. We had a great time last night, and just as good a time or better tonight. You're a great audience, and we thank you. And it's a real privilege for us to sing with one of the outstanding choruses of the whole United States International Society of St. Charles. Thank you.
out so we can hold it out a little bit. There's a gentleman out here. Are you a barbershopper, sir? No, I... Well, you should be. He's got a mustache that every barbershopper is envious of. Goodness gracious. Well, we meet every Thursday night, so we're looking for a mustache like that in our court. Oh, goodness. Now, that sounded real good, but I think the women are out singing the men so far. Yeah. To show them up now. The next song, God Rest You Merry Gentlemen, the first verse is just the guys, okay? Just the men skate on this one now. Guys, sing that good loud. Women, you can join us on the second verse so you have a whole verse to study the words, okay? God rest you. And
God rest you, merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior, was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's power and we were gone. Thank you.
We can now boast of two consecutive Central States District Championships and two consecutive finishes among the top 10 in international competition. This is dedication and vision of our director, David Wright. Now, as you may know, David turned over his director's baton this past summer to our current director, Jim Henry. David said he needed more time. David said he needed more time to work on other areas of our craft. Now he also has more time to write those great song arrangements he's so well known for in our society. Now, David also said he wanted to develop his skills as a solo vocalist. We can tell you, these past several months, David has been spending hours and hours of practice with his vocal coaches, drilling an intensive regimen of vocal exercises. Now tonight, all that hard work will surely yield an unforgettable vocal performance. Because tonight, ladies and gentlemen, the Daniel Boone Chorus proudly presents Professor David G. Wright as a featured soloist. Barbershop just isn't pretty. A promising career nipped in the bud, and we really apologize for that happening tonight on our stage. We do hope that this doesn't spoil your preparations for the holiday. Oh my. We've only heard this sound one other time, ladies and gentlemen, and this can only mean one thing. Further proof that Barbershop is not pretty. Will you please welcome the 1990 Central States District 5th place finalist quartet, Expanded Sound. Thank you.
And some may say we're even crude. It's hard to disagree that we lack dignity.
He sings the high part. animals originally from Buffalo. The rest of us are from normal parents. My name's Tank. I sing the hard part.
The way he does it, it is.
Behind me is the leader of the pack, Mad Dog. About this time of year, Animal always seems to get the blues. And the only way that we can get Animal out of that funk is to drag out the Christmas music. And that seems to soothe his savage breast. Few very nice Christmas songs.
My home's a place I want to be. When it's Christmas time, I'll be home for Christmas. His glorious ways loaded love.
I think
now present the 1988 Central States District Championship Quartet and the 1990 sixth place finalist at our international competition. Please welcome our very own Gas House Band.
Scalp begins to itch and flay. May your face afterglow. So.
Oh, she's
no.
No.
No. No. No.
You have tried this every day.
Tradition, we usually say, you know, that poem, 'Twas the Night Before Christmas, which you all know, and every year around our household, you know, the Henry family gets together and we say this poem, and so every year since we do it, you know, I figure that by now we have it mesmerized, and so right now what I'm going to do, if these guys don't mind, and even if they do, I'm going to go ahead and say this poem right now, and this is the night before Christmas. Well, thank you. That helps me get into the mood a little bit. So here we go. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. He knows this one. Not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in the hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. It was the night before Christmas, and all through the house, my creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The sights were hung by the chimney with care, in the hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Ma in my kerchief, and I in her cap, had just settled down for a long winter's nap, when, out on the lawn, a clatter. I wanted to see where the clatter was at. I sprang out of bed and stepped on the cat. Away to the window I flew like a flasher. Flash. Tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. When, what with my wandering eyes did I see but a sleigh and some reindeer and Santa Claus? E. More rapid than, faster than a speeding bullet. His forebears, they came, and he screamed, and he shouted, and called them a name. On Cupid, on Prancer, on Dasher, on. 'Twas the night before Christmas. He screamed, and he shouted, and called them a name. On Dasher, on Dancer, on Snoopy, on Vixen, on Dopey, on Lefty, on Reagan and Nixon. From the top of the roof to the top of the wall, my cat was pinned under my new bowling ball. Down the chimney, Santa Claus comes. It's a wonder he didn't burn off his buns. His clothes were all covered with ashes and soot, and he kicked the cat across the room with his shiny black foot. That's what rhymes. His eyes, how they tickled, his pimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose quite contrary. He was chubby and plump and as fat as a hog. And I laughed when I saw him. Hot diggity dog. He was putting the presents down under the tree with one if by land and two if by sea. Then laying his nose to his finger side, I happened to notice the cat had just died. Up the chimney he went and into his sleigh, and then with the whistle, they all flew away. Explain as he drove out of sight. With justice for all and to all of you.
carol that a lot of you have probably never heard before. And it's actually a Christmas carol that came from an old black spiritual. So it's a very old thing, and a lot of you have not heard it, so I hope you enjoy it. It's called Mary Had a Baby.
Mary had a baby.
Taxing made when Quirinius was governor of Syria, and all went to be taxed. each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth in Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary, who was great with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. Find the babe wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men."
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. For the Lord God, live on and pray.
The shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. The shepherds saw the baby. They made known the saying which had been told them concerning this child, and all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary kept all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen.
A star!
there's 400 seats available, and there's about 750 of you. So we want to see which one of you are the loyal ones. Come on out. I hear that the directions to get there, you just sort of go that way, and then you go that way. And that's all there is to it. You take Natural Bridge, you take Newhall's Ferry, and then you take a left. You take Newhall's Ferry sort of that south, right?
North.
Yeah, like I said, north. And you take off, boy, I bet none of you will come now. Go left on Houdershell. That I know I got. And it's just
Shackleford.
And follow the crowd. Before we go, we'd like to let you give more one round of applause to all the quartets that have helped us out tonight. There have been many people responsible for this show. I wish we had time to tell you all of them. But they know who they are, and so do we. But we would like to recognize the quartets one more time. This wonderful quartet is a brand new quartet, and they're not even completely sure of their name, but we're sure of their sound. Their name, for tonight at least, is First Capital Four. Raise your hand. Season. Would you please join with us now and help us sing Silent Night? Thank you.